Imagine your baby born with a disorder so rare it barely existed in medical literature. Then imagine the effects of that disorder medically reversed. AI actually helped Mayo doctors do just that. Rena Sargentopoulos shows us how, and how it could help others too.
Fly like a butterfly.
Ask any expecting parent, do you want a boy or a girl?
Where's your elbow? Nice!
The answer usually is, we just want them to be healthy.
You did it! Good job!
Going through IVF, Joni and Dave Kraus thought health issues were in the clear as genetic testing was done as part of the process.
We had our 20-week scan. They found out that she was a little bit small and they found an undefined heart issue. They didn't quite know what it was. And so we prayed for wisdom. And we went to Mayo for a second opinion.
At 33 weeks, the doctors at Mayo decided a C-section was the best option. Jorie Kraus was welcomed into the world.
And they immediately ended up putting her into one of those little incubator things and shipped her off over to the St. Mary's campus. Had both women in my life in two different buildings and trying to split time between both and keep them both okay.
Jorie would go on to spend 73 days in the NICU. It turned out she had not one, but five heart issues, among some other physical anomalies, but nothing that couldn't be overcome.
How are we going to fix it and how we're going to address it? And this wonderful surgeon told Dave, hey, don't worry about it. We're going to figure all of this out. You just need to worry about who she's taking to prom.
Joni and Dave allowed themselves to exhale, but it's not where their baby girl's story ends. Genetic testing came back, a problem. Jorie was missing part of her chromosome 10, a spontaneous deletion during pregnancy, meaning it was not inherited from either parent, which is why it wasn't caught during the IVF process. Jorie was diagnosed with DeSanto-Shinawi syndrome, a rare genetic disorder that was the cause of her physical issues, but would also cause low muscle tone, developmental delays, and intellectual disabilities. At the time, just a couple dozen people in the world had the same diagnosis.
Joni was asking a little bit about what does that mean, and I just sort of piped up and said that means it's permanent. There's nothing, this one doesn't have a fix. This one doesn't have a surgery. And that's when I had to get up and leave the room.
With no cure, early interventions like physical and speech therapies were the only options. A year passed, and as Jorie fell behind with her milestones like crawling and talking, Joni and Dave pushed forward, fighting for answers.
We're at the best hospital in the world. Where's the groundbreaking genetic research? And she had this smile, this big, big smile. And she goes, have you met Dr. Whitney Thompson?
They had, in fact, met Dr. Thompson. She was working in the NICU when they ordered the genetic testing or rapid genome sequencing for Jorie right after birth. And since that time, Dr. Thompson had started a new project with Dr. Laura Lambert, called Baby Force.
We can send this comprehensive genetic test day one in the NICU and get a diagnosis within that first week of life, and it can really make a huge difference for patients. But often we get the diagnosis, but we don't have a treatment, and that's really where Baby Force comes in.
The doctors take a patient's own skin cells and grow them in a lab. Using artificial intelligence, they search for already FDA-approved drugs that could potentially help. Then they test them on the patient's lab-grown cells to see if it works.
Taking a drug that's already approved and already known to be safe really circumvents all of those issues that the rare disease population faces. So we don't have to have that major investment into running a clinical trial because it's off-label use.
For Jorie, the top hit from AI was an inexpensive drug commonly used to treat seizures in children. In the lab, it worked like a charm, boosting the levels of the working chromosome to compensate for the deleted one. Since the concept is so new, they had to go through ethics and legal departments first. Jorie just started taking the medicine a few months ago. Turns out,
whoa!
It's working like a charm in real life, too.
Good job!
Within days, Jorie started going up and down stairs, walking with a walker, even starting to say words.
It's like she was getting the information in, understanding it, but then just couldn't figure out what to do with it.
Yeah.
And now she's starting to figure out what to do with it.
A treatment for an ultra-rare disease would normally take years, if at all. The success in Jorie's case opens a door of hope for others in the future.
We're focused on the NICU because certainly the earlier we intervene, potentially the more impact we can have on somebody's life. And the hope is we can move that timeline up even more and start treating before symptoms even develop.
We know this could benefit patients who are born with genetic differences, but it also has applications for cancer, for example, where we could sequence an individual's tumor and understand what's causing the cancer and look for drugs using AI to try to have an impact for those patients as well.
Okay, let's go, 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 go.
Endless possibilities.
Whee!
Which is also what these doctors have given Jorie.
She's going to be the best Jorie that she can be. The barriers have been removed from her.
She's just such a joy. And, you know, we just hope that out of all the hardship that we went through and all that she has gone through, that it will be a beacon of hope to others.
I did it!
Now, none of this is covered by insurance. It was all funded by Mayo and private donors, so Joni and Dave want to pay it forward. They started a GoFundMe and a charity called the Jorie Effect to help others get access to this care. You can find links to both of those with this story on care11.com. We also did extensive interviews with Joni and the doctors. You can watch the entire 30-minute special on the Jorie Effect right now on Care11+. Now, she will have some physical things that she still has to overcome, but It's
miraculous.
It is. Yeah. It is. And that's nothing short. Like, that's a word that you have to be careful with. But yeah, like, it's for their family. It's been miraculous.
First of all, she's so darling.
I know.
Oh, my gosh. What a darling girl. And you can just see the joy in their faces.
Yeah.
But when they take those cells, also, that doesn't seem like an invasive procedure even.
No.
To get this whole process started.
Not at all. It's just some skin cells. She was in for another procedure, so they grabbed some when they did that. I know. It's truly
and those
remarkable.
Doctors, they're so young.
I know.
That's so
it's
brilliant.
Killing me, and I love it.
I know.
I love this whole, I mean, how smart and how young and how much the future of doctors, if you have those folks thinking that way, just thinking outside the box.
Outside
completely.
The box. And they are publishing at the end of July, so going to be a big deal.
Wow.
Big
Great
deal.
Story.
That is a big
our
deal.
Best, our best to Joni and her family. Beautiful family.